I didn't see any in Nirvana records, but it's too,
no, there's,
too
there's
obvious.
A, there's
too
never
obvious.
Mind.
This is Extinción, the Looking for an Answer. I think it came out in 2007, and ever since I listened to it for the first time, this band became one of my favorite bands of all times. A part of having a kind of a good friendship with one of the guys, I have this album on my MP3 player, and I listen to it every second or third day, because I never change the music in my MP3. I saw them live in Barcelona like some years ago, about like 2009 I think, or 2008, or I don't know. And they were playing this album, and there are a couple of video clips from that night on YouTube that are like very well edited and kind of official.
In Estraperlo?
Yeah.
Oh, okay,
and
yeah.
I was at that show, and that was probably the first time I saw them live, and it's for sure Looking for an Answer is one of my favorite bands. So this is my choice from Luis Ifer collection. Yeah, I recently got Dios Carne on CD. Felix sent it to me, and Eterno Terblinka, I still have it on my MP3 player too. I don't have it original, but I love them. But for some reason, this one I got to listen to it most.
Nuestro respeto es nuestro desprecio, third song. The breakdown to that song,
yeah.
I'd say that's one of my, it could be one of my favorite grindcore songs,
yeah.
Ever. Top 10 grindcore songs.
Yeah, also the fact that it's a vegan vegetarian band,
yeah,
gives a bonus plus kind of thing for me.
Album 2 from Led Zeppelin. This is probably one of the albums that I listened the most when I was a kid. Dad is a big fan of classic rock. Since I was born, I was listening to Pink Floyd, Led Zeppelin, Deep Purple at home. Deep Purple was actually my favorite memory from my childhood, because it was my first rock concert when I was 10. And
you saw Deep Purple when you were 10?
I saw Deep Purple when I was 10. I remember at that show there was like a lot of people smoking weed around us, and he was telling me like, hey listen, this is not the real rock and roll, you know, like you don't have to do drugs to be rock and roll.
But here you are.
You know? But
here,
yeah,
you are doing drugs.
I took some stuff serious and some stuff I didn't really, you know. But
so would you say you like Led Zeppelin more than Pink Floyd?
No, but you don't have any Pink Floyed.
Oh, yeah,
or at least I didn't see
I
it.
I have Wish You Were Here and The Wall.
Okay. I just bought Wish You Were Here on our last Asian tour. I bought the Japanese edition of the vinyl from 75.
From 1970, like original pressing?
Yeah, yeah, original pressing
from
the Japanese edition. Yeah, yeah. Those guitar notes on, first notes on Shine On, You Pray to Diamond.
That's the perfect example of why vinyl is important. Like, I think about that album as a side A and side B. I don't even
sure.
think about
yeah,
it
yeah,
for
yeah.
like songs.
Yeah. Sure.
Or
totally.
A whole album, yeah.
Totally. It's a whole thing. Also, because you have like, the first song starts on the first song and it ends on the last song.
Yeah.
You know, it's like this
yeah, it's a whole
huge 26-minute song if you put it together. So fucking awesome. This is I Am King from the band Code Orange. It's honestly one of my favorite bands nowadays. Like everything they do has been impressing me like since day one. Just look at those faces. They're so fucking young, you know, and they have so much anger. It's really great. Now they put out a new one. It's Forever. It was like number one everywhere, Grammy nominated, whatever, you know, like this band is
would you growing. Say you like this album more than Forever?
I don't know what to say. I really like this one. Maybe this is more like it has more of a pure hardcore vibe, and Forever it has all this new influences, you know, some grunge, some industrial, all mixed up. I think it's done in a genius way, but maybe I found this more genuine, I don't know, but fucking love both, and I really love
what it. I really like about Code Orange, in my opinion, is I feel like for me this album's very good, Forever is a little bit better, and I get the feeling like the next album will be even a bit better. It's one of those bands where I think they're just gonna get better and better.
Sure, non-stop growing. But yeah, go there.
It's rehashed by MacGruber Grind.
Mm-hmm. I was on this album pretty a lot. In summer 2012, I listened to it nearly every day. I really like the roughness of the production. And the songs are pretty short and on the point. Every of them. I know every drum feel by heart, so it's pretty nice.
I can tell true.
No, yeah.
It's totally true.
But somehow I lost my love to them a little bit.
Yeah?
I mean, maybe because of the drummer. I mean, the new drummer is good, but Chris Moore is outstanding, no question.
I've seen Magruder Grind with Chris Moore several times, but I remember seeing Coke Bust, where Chris Moore plays, with Alvaro, our drummer, and I have never seen like his face react to a drummer like when he saw Chris Moore. I looked at his face and he told me he's like, best drummer I've ever seen.
It's crazy. Paul Rowland's Grind masterpiece.
Yeah, my choice was actually this, In Communication by the Beastie Boys, which is probably one of my top five favorite bands ever. I mean, this way, it came in, it was 1994, I think, which was a really...
Yes, 94.
Was great year for music. I mean, how many great albums came out in that year? I mean, there is Sabotage in this album, so...
What I like about that album, well, about the Beastie Boys, it's hardcore kids making
They come
hip-hop.
From hardcore, yeah. You know.
And there's hardcore songs on
that
album.
Yeah, exactly, that's the point. And you can feel the difference. I mean, white people from New York, from the hardcore scene, doing hip-hop in a great way. And I'm really... I have really great feelings about Beastie Boys because I had the chance to see them live. It was back in 2003, and it was one of the best shows I've seen in my whole life. It was like a 3-hour show, and it was great because it was four parts. First part were them with of course the scene, everything were in red costumes all together. Doing hip-hop stuff, then the stage turned, and it was like a, I don't know how to describe it, you know, on a nave da crociera?
A cruise
boat,
uh-huh.
As an orchestra, playing stuff, you know, the funky period, so all instrumental, with percussion or something. Then they turn back again on the stage, with the blue dresses, doing hip-hop stuff, from Hello Nasty Period or something. Then the last part they turn again and it was just the three of them dressed like this with shirts and playing the hardcore stuff, and the very last song was Sabotage.
Wow.
I can still remember the feeling of the sound, the bass and the whole fucking venue vibrating. I was like this. That this record is a pretty could sum up pretty much. Of course, also Check Your Head, the number four is another one. But also this album can sum up pretty much the whole spirit of the Beastie Boys.